This is the summing up of the natural law of the relation between us and the divine mind. It is thus no vain boast that mental science can enable us to make our lives what we will. We must start from where we are now, and by rightly estimating our relation to the divine, universal mind, we can gradually grow into any conditions we desire, provided we first make ourselves in habitual mental attitude the person who corresponds to those conditions. For we can never get over the law of correspondence, and the externalization will always be in accord with the internal principle that gives rise to it. And to this law there is no limit. What it can do for us today, it can do tomorrow. And through all that procession of tomorrows that loses itself in the dim vistas of eternity, belief in limitation is the only and one thing that causes limitation, because we thus impress limitation upon the creative principle. And as we lay that belief aside, our boundaries will expand, and increasing life and more abundant blessings will be ours. But we must not ignore our responsibilities. Trained thought is far more powerful than untrained, and therefore the more deeply we penetrate into mental science, the more carefully we must guard against all thoughts and words expressive of even the most modified form of ill will. Gossip, tale-bearing, sneering laughter are not in accord with the principles of mental science. And similarly, even our smallest thoughts of good carry with them a seed of good, which will assuredly bear fruit in good time.